So thank you very much once again, all of you. Welcome back. Welcome back to the Spoken English demo class for the first time forever in my show. So here go. There are 22 students in my institute who, for them, I am conducting this show on the Sunday from different location. They will join and give their opinion today. So thank you very much once again. Please be welcome to my demo class. First of all, before we conducting class, we understand what do we mean by spoken English, and we have another hand received by the communication trainer. So please join with me, and we too have a brief idea to giving our student and providing the best possible way how they can develop their communication skill. Rashid Wal Wahid is my, very soon he's going to join my show, and along with some basic tips for the student how they can develop their communication skill. So before we starting this class, I will educate you that spoken English nowadays very very necessary. Spoken English class is really necessary. It helps to enhance our skill and to represent ourselves with public. So communication is an essential part of daily life. Very soon my students will join in this show. Panasmita, if you watching this show, please join and please send me the request. I will accept from my end. Himadri Tanaya Swain. Study Samal, please, they are watching, please join with me and give your introduction over here so that we have to clear your doubt and give you the direction, the command. By following this, you can improve your communication skill. So yeah, so very soon they are going to join my show. Before that, I am giving some basic tips so that you can improve your communication skill. That is the fourth thing is really necessary to develop anyone. That is reading, writing, listening, and then speaking. These are fourth essential elements you need to follow. The first thing you need to understand, that is reading. Reading plays a very vital role in our daily life, because if you read, you can remember, you can understand the language, you can understand the word formation. So reading plays a very crucial part in our daily life. So second one is listening. There is a proverb called that if you want to be good speaker, you have to be good listener. So listen very carefully what you are trying to say. Study Samal, please join with us. Study, please join and give your introduction part over here. The students are watching my show. They definitely will going to join in my show.
Whosoever wants to join, please give me the request and you can give your introduction over here so that it will be a very, very beautiful things over here. So talking about the listening part, to be a good speaker, you have to be a good listener first. So you have to listen very, very carefully. So if you listening daily basis or listen to our news channel or any other thing, Stari Samal is unable to join over here. What is the reason behind it? I don't know, but Madri, if you watching this show, please invite me in the request. I will check you in my show and you will give your introduction part and speak about 2 minutes for any topic. So yes, so we're checking about the listening part. So listening is also very essential part of spoken English. So please be listen very carefully any things in terms of English. You can listen news channel, you can listen any motivational video of the English, you can listen the story, comics, poetry, and everything. It will help you to develop your communication skill. And another thing is understanding or observing, because understanding is really necessary for everyone, because you need to understand before you trying to say. Recipe is not, it's not good. Why you are watching this? I am going to add you and you are trying to say that. Okay, so understanding means you need to understand the English first. You need to understand the language, you need to understand that word, and hence it will help you to develop your communication skills. So these four things is really necessary to develop your communication skill. The first one is reading, writing, listening, and understanding. If you carry these four things in your mind or in your daily life, definitely will develop your communication skill, no doubt about that. So before that, I am giving some basic tips or basic procedure or basic policy so that you can improve. That is called self-introduction part. Self-introduction, because the first impression is called the last impression. Any kind of interview, anywhere you can go, the first and the foremost things you need to understand, that the first question arises from anyone, that is the self-introduction part. Tell me about yourself, which is very much necessary. And if you say this effective way, and if you elaborate yourself in a very beautiful way, believe me, the 90% interview are clear. Because the self-introduction part is very much essential and plays a very crucial role during your interview. So coming to the point, what should we say in our self-introduction part? I need to understand what are the techniques, how we speak while someone is asking us to give your self-introduction. So you can use, my name is so-and-so, myself so-and-so, I am so-and-so, here is, this is, you can use. But in the latest, the current version, if I using here is or this is, that will be much effective. Because if you say, I am so-and-so, my name is so-and-so, myself so-and-so, so it's a very old tradition. So you use here is or this is, that will be more effective or more benefit. And it's so that you have lots of courage and you have lots of self-confidence level. So you can use, here is Pavitra Naik, or here is so-and-so, or here is Vishal Patnaik. That will be much better. Or this is so-and-so. So before that, you will wish good afternoon, good morning, whatever the time period is. And after that, you can say this line, your reach. So then you need to say that the interviewer that thank you for giving me us this golden opportunity. Thank you giving me this wonderful opportunity to elaborate myself in front of you. That line must be added in your CV or in your self-introduction part. Because it shows that you have a good amount of gratitude. Because the interviewer giving you the opportunity to speak, and that's and you have the courtesy from your end, and you have the that much of gratitude from your end that you have to speak that thanks for giving me this golden opportunity, or thanks for giving me this wonderful platform to introduce myself. And believe me, if you add this line or if you speak this line, your self-confidence level will be getting more higher. So after that, you can use that I am from this place or I belongs to. Remember, please, if you are watching my show, please write it down in your note. Or Vanaspita, if you are watching my show, please give me the invitation from your end. I will add you in my show, Vanaspita. Or if you say I am from this place, it's okay. Or you can use I belongs to. You cannot use that I am belongs from. Thank you very much, all the viewers watching. I am giving. If you are watching my show, please write it down in a note. And here you go. Vanasmita is adding over here. Vanasmita, please welcome and welcome to my Instagram live.
Thank you, sir.
Vanasmita, are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Please be louder. And I will give you that Vanasmita is my student in my institute. She wants to develop her communication skill, and she is right now pursuing the first year, and she's clearing the OTT exam. Right now, she is going to give her introduction. Please be listen and very carefully what she's trying to say over here. Vanaspinda, please go ahead and tell me about yourself. Vanaspinda, your voice is breaking. Vanaspita, your voice is breaking.
Sorry, sir, some network issues.
Okay. Now it's working. Please go ahead.
Good morning, everyone. First of all, thank you for this giving me this wonderful opportunity to introduce myself, and a very special thank you to sir to take a part. Giving me this opportunity to take place in this platform. My name is Vanasmita Raut. I am from Jagatsinghpur, Odisha. I am pursuing my BSc first year in Zoology Honours in SSJ Mahavidyalaya from Utkal University, Odisha. I have completed my diploma in elementary education in 2021. I am belonging from a lower middle class family. My father is a businessman and my mother is a housemaker. My biggest strength is I'm a very confident person. Apart from that, I'm very hardworking and self-motivator. My hobbies are listening to music, listening Hindi poetry, reading books, and watching World Affairs on YouTube. My goals is to be a teacher. That's all about me. Thank you, sir, for giving me this precious time, and thank you to everyone for listening to me. Thank you.
Very nice, very nice. And Banasmita, your confidence level is very nice, and that's a very positive sign. And Banasmita, tell me about any topic for 2 minutes.
Sir, nowadays, education is most important in our life, so I want to I want to say about the importance of education in our day-to-day life. So can I say?
Yeah, please go ahead. And Banasmita, ladies and gentlemen, those who are watching my show, I want to tell you that Banasmita will tell about the importance of the education, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, please go ahead.
So, good morning, everyone. I want to say about importance of education in our day-to-day life. You all know that education is very, very important in our life. Nowadays, education is the basic needs of our life. Without education, we can't go out securely. Without education, we can't imagine it for a better life. We also can say that education is the backbone of our society. It gives us confidence and strength. Your personality doesn't mean how poor you are, how much money you have, whose position you have, or how much degree you have, or where are you belonging from, but it means how educated you are. Education brings us perfection, so it is said that manufacturers of perfection is the real education. And then I want to tell you all that the needs of education in our day-to-day life, there is no better investment than an investment of knowledge. And in modern society, and modern society is also aware of this. This is why education and proper schooling of children is today's top priorities. Education in society. Can I say?
Please go ahead. Your voice is breaking due to some networking. So please go ahead. It sounds good.
Education in society gives us better quality. Education and also everywhere. If we want to educate our country, then we should all mothers. It is said that sir, are you listening to me?
Yeah, I'm listening to you.
If you want to develop or educate our country, first educate all mothers. So it is said that if we educate a person, we educate only a person, but if we educate a mother, we educate a family. That's why our country will grow rapidly.
Yes.
And with the help of education, we gain confidence and overcome the disease called failure. Education shows us the path of success. So, Sir APJ Abdul Kalam said that confidence and hard work is the best medicine to kill the disease called failure, and it will make you a successful person. For a better education, the best medium can be integrated into account for learning books and also the best source for knowledge and education. If we go through the movies, there are a dialogue of Miss Katrina Kaif. If I think you also are knows Miss Katrina Kaif, so there have some dialogue that books are the best friends of humans. There have no questions and no demands. And yes, I agree with this. And also, APJ Abdul Kalam also said that one best book is equal to 100 good friends, but one best friend is equal to a library. So above all the discussion, we learned that we should get positive approach from our environment through education. And the best source is our family, our environment, society, and our learning books. We should make friendship with them and live life with a meaningful way. And then I want to say that quality life needs quality education, and quality education depends upon how we are aware of this and how we understand the importance of education. Education gives our thoughts and give opinion on different problematic situations. With the help of education, we can develop our communication skill. And through the education and communication skill, we can comfortable anywhere. So last of all, I want to say that we should be educated, and thank you all for giving me your precious time and listening to me for some seconds or some minutes. And thank you, everyone.
Very nice, very nice. So, sister, tell us a very beautiful speech about the importance of education. Thank you, Banasmita, for joining us. And you can leave from your end. Thank you very much for giving this precious time to me. Thank you, Banasmita. Have a good day.
Thank you, sir. Have a good day.
Okay, you can leave from your end, Banasmita. Thank you.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. So you can listen to my one of my student. She is giving her introduction part. Apart from that, he speaks about the importance of education at least for 5 minutes. That's a very, very positive sign. So anyone wants to join and speak about the introduction part, you can send me the request. I will add over here, or you can give me the comment. So we're living at the part that is called self-introduction level. So first of all, you want to wish, whether it's a time, good afternoon, good morning, or good evening, whatever the time period is. Then you have to say that thanks for giving me this golden or wonderful opportunity to speak about myself. And I belongs to this area. Suppose I can say that my name is, or here is Pavitra Naik, I belongs to Jagatsinghpur. And after that, I will say that ki Jagatsinghpur, why Jagatsinghpur is famous? You can add this line in your interview, that Jagatsinghpur is a very beautiful place, and it's famous for the Sarala Temple, Baba Goraknath Temple, and the Paradip Fort. So you can add this line. It will be more effective while you're speaking. And when... because if you add this sentence, the interviewer will understand that the person is really concerned about of her motherland or of his or her area. Because you have to respect your motherland first. If you are belongs from Odisha, you have to say that Odisha is a very wonderful place. So this kind of sentence you can add in your CV or while you speak about yourself. So after that, you can say about your education qualification. For that, you have to, first of all, you have to say your highest education qualification. For example, if someone is doing MCOM, MA, MSc, or any other master degree, you can say that I have completed this this graduation, and right now I'm pursuing this these things. If I want to say from myself that I have completed my master degree, MBA, master in business administration from this year or in this college. For example, I am showing the demo. I have completed my master degree, master in business administration in 2014 at International School of Business Management, Bhubaneswar. So you can add, after that, you can, if you have some experience, or if you are a fresher, there's no need to say. If you are experienced, then you can say that I have this much of year, this much years or months of experience from this organization or this company or this kind of particular field. Getting my point? If you have any other comments, or if you have any other doubt, please give me the comments box, or you can write it down. And after that, after telling your highest qualification, you must say about your family background, or in your family background, you have to mention your father's occupation, your mother's occupation, and how many brothers and sisters that you have. For example, if I say that my family consists of 6 members, where my father is a businessman, my mother is a housewife. You cannot say that your mother is a housewife. That's a very wrong word. You can say, yes, Himadri, you can please go ahead and send me the request. Himadri, please go ahead and send me the request. I'll add in my show, and please give your introduction. Yes, if I will say that my family is consist of 6 members, where my father is a businessman and my mother is a housemaker or homemaker. And I have one elder sister, and that's all about my family. This is how you can elaborate yourself. And after that, you can say your hobbies. Hobbies means what kind of activities you would like to do in daily basis. It can be playing cricket, watching cricket. It can be reading books, dance, singing songs, and drawing, painting, visiting, traveling, plantation. Any kind of hobbies are there. Don't be hesitant to say your hobbies, because from that, the interviewer will judge you. So please mention your hobby. For me, if anyone asks me that, what's your hobby, sir? I must say that my hobbies are doing commentary, or watching cricket, reading newspaper, or providing the spoken class to the students. That's my hobbies. I love to do that kind of things. So if your hobbies something like playing cricket or dancing, you can add this kind of things in your self-introduction part. And after that, you can say that your strength area, that means what are the quality that a person will hire you? ऐसा आपके अंदर क्या quality है, ऐसा क्या extraordinary talent है, कुछ talent है जिसके बावजूद आपको interview में select करा जाएगा. So that's a very important point. You can add that I am very optimistic, positive, self-motivated person, and I am very punctual, I am very hardworking, and I am very much positive person. So you can say this kind of things in your strength area. Or about your weakness, you can say that I am not a multitaskable person. I cannot do or I cannot concentrate the same tasks or same work at one time. Do not say your weakness in front of anyone. That's a very, very important point you have to keep in your mind. And after that, you must say that what is your goal, what is your objective. If you want to become a teacher, if you want to become a doctor, IAS officer, OAS officer, anything, any kind of dream that you have, you must have to mention over there. For example, if someone wants to become a doctor, or someone wants to become a lecturer, or someone wants to become an IAS officer, you can say, I want to become an IAS officer. Because it's your dream. And you have to say that what is your goal, what is your objective. So these are the parameters, these are the lines you need to mention in your CV or while you're speaking about yourself. Right? If you have any doubt, please comments me, or please give your comments. I will going to educate you properly how you give your introduction level, or how you can speak in front of anyone. Because self-introduction level is very much essential nowadays. Self-introduction level is very, very essential nowadays. You have to speak, because 90% of the 90% chance to crack the interview level is depend upon your self-introduction part. So Himadri, if you want to if you want to say something in my life, so please go ahead and speak about yourself and a speech about for 2 to 3 minutes. So these are the basic tips I have already given you. If you really want to develop your communication skill, or if you are really develop your English language or English skill, because why English language is so popular nowadays or in the world? Because English, you can say, one of the prestigious language, one of the demand language all over the world. because without English you cannot survive in this world. Okay, Himadri Tanaya Singh, one of my student, is going to add over here and say wants to give your introduction, and she wants to speak about a topic for at least 2 minutes. Himadri Tanaya Singh, please welcome to my show. Himadri, are you there? Make sure that there is no such networking issues going on. Yes, Himadri.
Good morning, sir.
Very good morning. How are you?
I am fine, sir.
Okay. So, Himadri, happy Sunday to you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Please tell me about yourself.
Good morning, sir. First of all, thank you for giving me this opportunity to introduce myself.
Okay.
Here is Himadri Tanaya Swain. I am belongs from Jagat Singhpur.
Yes.
Now I am pursuing graduation in Adikavi Saradas College, Tirtol.
Okay.
My hobbies are reading and listening music.
Okay.
My strength is my family. And I am a very hardworking and self-motivated girl. My short-term goal is to achieve a good job. And my long-term goal is to become a lecturer. There are 3 members, including my family, my father and my mother, and also me. My father's name is Sriman Swain. He is a private job holder. And my mother's name is Sasmita Swain. She is a housemaker.
Okay.
That's all about myself. Thank you.
What is your strength area, Himadri?
My strength area is my family. And I am a very, very hardworking and self-motivated girl.
Okay, very nice. And what is your weakness point? What is your weak area?
My weakness is my angriness. And it is also my weakness and strength.
Okay. Very, very good. Daughter. Himadri, please tell me about any topic for 2 to 3 minutes at least. Whatever comfortable. Any topic, are you comfortable? Please go ahead and speak at least for 2 to 3 minutes.
So I am telling about something is better than nothing.
Okay, very nice. Go ahead.
First of all, thanks to give me great opportunity. This may sound like a confusing topic, but it can be taken in many different ways, which may add interest to the writing. For example, you may consider whether doing something is better than doing nothing, or whether having something is better than having nothing. Some people complain about not having enough time to do what they want to do. Everyone has the same amount of time every day.
Okay.
It is just what you choose to add with your time.
Okay.
Some people complain about not having enough money or toys.
Okay.
They appreciate what they do have.
Okay.
For examples, disease, problems, struggles, or challenges, yet most people don't apply these types of things to this topic.
Okay.
The stone writers did not have paper, yet there was still some advantages to writing on stone. Mostly the ability to last and not decay. Thanks,
Very
sir,
nice.
giving me your time.
Thank you very much, Simha. Thank you very much. Your confidence level is really good, and the way you are speaking is really excellent. Good job. Keep it up, it boy, beta. Very nice. Well done. So these are my two students. Give their introduction part and speak about any topic for 2 minutes. Yes, you have to practice regularly. If you want to become fluent in the English, you need to have that much kind of practice or giving your valuable time. Because if you don't want to develop your communication skill, nobody else in the world can help you. So you have to say at least whether it is wrong or right. Don't go for the grammatical error first. You have to speak. You have to speak. Doesn't matter. It's a grammatical mistake or there. And I am giving you some tips that every day choose a topic, and you can search in the Google, choose a topic. For example, if you can say that it's, for example, something is better than nothing, choose this topic and speak for 2 minutes. Choose a topic just like importance of education, global warming, impact of COVID-19 or COVID in our education system, importance of water, importance of punctuality, importance of discipline. You can choose this kind of topic and just write it down, the 10 valuable points in your note, and practice it in front of a mirror. Loudly speak in front of a mirror. That's why you can energize your confidence, or you can build your self-confidence level. That's a very good technique or procedure. So thank you very much, all the viewers watching my show. If you have any comments, please give me. I will try to solve this problem. Or anybody wants to join my spoken English class through online or through Zoom application, you can just ping me in my Instagram, or you can just ping me in my WhatsApp. There is a number I have given in the description below, 9650923960. Or if you want to get the offline class benefit, please come to my institute, which is located in the Tirthol Anand Mandap. The institute name is Gitanjali Institute, where we can give training the spoken English, ZD group discussion, personal interview, and communication skill, and also giving 100% placement over there. Apart from that, we are providing the course like computer, PC, DCA, or DCA, Trolley, networking, Java, C++, or any kind of software course you can get available from there. And from that, we also providing the coaching of plus one, plus three, all the students like arts and commerce, and also all the CBSE and ICSE board, class of 5 to 10, you can join in my institute and get benefit over there. So thank you very much, all the viewers. Or if anybody wants to join my show or wants to speak about English for 2 minutes, you can go ahead and can speak. So okay, so today I am giving 10 important line that is called a polite phrase, जो कि हम डेली बेसिस में उसको यूज करते हैं, चाहे मीटिंग में हो, चाहे क्लासरूम में हो, चाहे अपना ऑफिस की जॉब में हो, चाहे बिजनेस वर्क में हो, किसी भी फील्ड में हम यूज करते हैं पोलाइट फेज. सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सम पोलाइट फेज. आई विल स्पीक इन ओडिया एंड देन आई विल ट्रांसलेट इट इन टू द इंग्लिश. प्लीज गिव योर अटेंशन प्लीज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ समवन विल से मी दैट मु साक्षात करने को समय दे थी. Okay, what kind of sentence you can use over here? I could make my time to meet you. Okay, If you can say that mu tumaku sakhyata karibaku samay deithili kintu mu asi parli nahi mate kshama karantu. Suppose you can say that I am sorry I could not make it that day. Simple. I am sorry I could not make it that day. Suppose you are sitting on a meeting. तुम्हें माने मीटिंग रे बसिच और यू वांट टू स्पीक समथिंग तुम्हें किसी कह चाहूच तो केमती कह सपोज मु कह मत कह दियंतु मत कह दियंतु सो यू कैन से अलाउ मी टू से प्लीज अलाउ मी टू से यू कैन यूज दिस काइंड ऑफ सेंटेंस नंबर थ्री एम आसवा मु क्षमा मागुची मु तुमको क्षमा मागुची आई बेग युअर पार्डन आई बेग युअर पार्डन आई एम रिपीटिंग वंस अगेन आई बेग युअर पार्डन ओके टिकिए ध्यान दियंतु यू कैन से मे आई हैव अटेंशन प्लीज मे आई हैव युअर अटेंशन प्लीज यू कैन से लाइक दिस ए जो सेंटेंस सब वी कैन यूज इन द डेली बेसिस daily simple sentence you can use it in your with your friend circle with your office with your business circle or while you talking with your friends or you chatting with your friends any kind of circumstances or situation you can use this kind of sentence in daily basis so that you can improve your communication skill so suppose jadi ami janu kahiba aramare basantu आरामरे बसंतु सो आम एमती कही परिवा कि प्लीज मेक योर सेल्फ कंफर्टेबल प्लीज मेक योर सेल्फ कंफर्टेबल टिकिए मते कहिबाकु देबे कि सपोज तमे तुम गोटे मीटिंग रे अछो या तो कोनो डिस्कशन चली छि तुमे चाहूचो किछ कहिबा पई तो टिकिए मते कहिबाकु देबो कि तार इंग्लिश कोन हबो विल यू परमिट मी टू स्पीक I may repeat once again. Will you permit me to speak? Tikiye dhire kahibe ki? Tikiye dhire kahibe ki? Will you please speak slowly? Will you please speak slowly? Mo pakheru khyama magi niyantu. Mo pakheru khyama magi niyantu. Ta English kon hobo? Please convey my apology. Please convey my apology. So these kind of sentence you can use in the daily basis while you trying to improve your speaking skill. So from here we are going to end this class. I hope you will all are enjoying this class. Or किसी प्रकार के अगर आपका doubt आता है, if you want facing any problem, if you are trying to speak in English, सबुठारु बड़ा कथा मुको बड़ा tips कहूँची. Don't be fear at all. Do not fear or don't think that कि दूसरे वाले इंसान क्या सोचेगा if you are trying something wrong, if you are telling something wrong in front of any other, दूसरे लोग क्या सोचेंगे? Please don't think like that. You need to speak whether it's a wrong or right because you yourself can develop your communication skills. So this is how you can improve yourself. So if you want to join my class in a regular basis, or please ping me in my Instagram, or please ping me in my WhatsApp. So I will giving some basic tips, and I will conduct the online classes in the Zoom application or Google Meet as per your requirements, as per your convenient time or schedule. So thank you very much once again, all the viewers watching my show. And I hope you all are enjoying this show. And if you have any other suggestion, if you have any other points to make this show more interesting, more beautiful, please, there is a comment section. You can give your comments. I will take in your feedback as in a positive way and hence want to improve our class. So every Sunday, I will be with you in Instagram Live or YouTube Live. If you want to, follow me in the YouTube, please go to YouTube application and subscribe Cricket with Pavitra. Cricket with Pavitra. Please share, subscribe, and press the likes item. Or I will also conduct some program in my YouTube channel very soon. For example, Spoken English day 1 to day 30. All the series I will cover in my YouTube. You can go there and search search in sequence wise. You can also get benefit by sitting in your home. So thank you very much once again for giving your precious time. Hope you all are enjoying this show. So see you on the next Sunday exactly at 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. 2 hours I am going to conducting the workshop the next Sunday. Please be with me. Or if you have any doubt, please ping me in WhatsApp, or you can call me, or you can follow me on Instagram and ping the message. Thank you very much. Hope for you all are doing wonderful. Have a great day. Thank you. And here we are going to close this show. Thank you very much.